we've got like big wigs in the house. I know it's a really big deal, and I'm really excited for the show.
And this time it's not actually wigs. So if you come to SPSM, you come for expert to expert content talking about what's new in innovation in suicide prevention.
I am an open data evangelist and innovator, and most excited about how do we solve complex, wicked challenges.
We're gonna learn about cryptocoin currency mining, go!
And suicide prevention is one of those wicked challenges.
But I wanna talk about the National Day of Civic Hacking.
Suicide and big data have this really, frankly, exciting future.
There's a different events. Sometimes they're called data jams, sometimes they're called hackathons. Big ones can sometimes be called data paloozas.
You know, the technology and the data parts actually, we can figure those things out. It's right now. It's getting all the people to the table and getting them a part of the process.
So you never know where innovation is going to come from, but from often the most unexpected places.
How do you go from idea to impact as rapidly as possible?
You can search through the data sets to see what kind of data is available, and you can also make requests for data that you need that isn't there, right?
So if you go to data.gov/contact, and you can't find what you're looking for, you can put in requests, and we sort of think of it like a concierge service, and you will get routed to the right people, the right agency, the right owners.
One of the things that we're seeing is we're moving towards a public health model, both in the suicide crisis and in the opioid crisis.
So yesterday's National Day of Civic Hacking was very much that, where we had five priority themes, themes such as open data for hurricane disaster relief, open government, Lyme disease solutions, data-driven solutions to the opioid crisis, and suicide prevention innovations.
We have to know where we want to go, and we have to know what we are going to need before we actually have the ability to gain it.
We want to unlock federal data that will be of most value to the outside.
We really need ethics standards and practices, and they need to be published and formalized, because there are a whole lot of people that rely on established precedent to make decisions about what can be done.
But when we set up data.gov, local, state, tribal, and international, other nations unlock their data. So that was really interesting, but also nonprofits.
Some of us are working on very different challenges, but we may be innovating tools that each other can use.
If you look at most really big changes and insights, they're not necessarily new ideas. They're ideas that are applied in new ways to completely unrelated disciplines.
We've got systems in place now with just a little bit of resources. We can actually have a really good, robust, a self-updating system that everybody could have access to, right? So the data's out there, we're just not really connecting the dots very well.
We want to have the events, we want to have the connection, the relationship, and then a pathway for funding.
There's a lot of things that folks with lived experience of suicidality crowdsource and geolocate, including where all sorts of different mental health resources are and how to use them.
So once we know what the solutions are, then we can scale what works.
People will freely give up their data to get a free app. But you put a website out there like our data helps, right? And it's hard to get lots of people to give their data.
So let's all shine a light, a loving light, on these things that matter and talk about them.
And if you ask enough people, sometimes you'll find that people have problems and solutions, and you match them up like you're matching up mismatched socks in your basket of laundry. It's just sometimes you come across two that match.
Collaborate with us, let us know how we can help, and make a lot of noise, and we will respond to that demand signal.
Be curious, ask questions, help people connect.
But this idea of a meme is information that replicates itself, right? And what you guys are really doing is you're creating a meme about information and helping replication, and it's building and it's kind of exploding.
We have a lot of researchers lined up ready to do research. We have a lot of people who want us to have their data. And we've got in the importance of being ethical with it in the middle, and decision makers who need to know what the standard is.